All right. So good morning, good evening, good afternoon, depending on your time zone. So in this particular talk, we'll be focusing on key differences between the Azure Logic Apps and Microsoft Power Automate. So who am I? My name is Prashant G. Boyer. I was raised in India, came to the United States in 2007 for studies, and University of Maryland College Park alumni co-authored a book called PowerShell for Office 65. I also acted as a technical reviewer for the book Pro SharePoint 2013 Administration. I am from Washington, D.C. area, and we organize a lot of community conferences. Pre-COVID pandemic, all the conferences used to be in person. Ever since the pandemic has started, we have converted all our conferences to virtual only. So if you're interested, here's the link, and you can find more information about registration and the call for speaker and rest of the stuff. I am recipient of Antarctic Service Medal. I got this award from U.S. government for the work I did in Antarctic continent back in 2008. I am recipient of Microsoft MVP award since 2017, and my current category is AI. And those of you who are not familiar with this award, so I don't work for Microsoft. It's just the additional recognition that Microsoft gives out to the folks who does technical contributions via various ways. And currently, I work as Cloud Solution Architect at AIS, and I focus on intelligent business process automation, where I use a variety of the products and services in Microsoft ecosystem, like Azure AI, bots, Microsoft Power Platform, Microsoft 65, and SharePoint. And I work at AIS Reston, Virginia headquarters. So this is going to be the agenda. We'll start with a brief introduction about Power Automate, a brief introduction about Logic Apps. And the majority of the time we'll be spending on talking about the key differences between these two products. I'll also talk about how to extend Microsoft Flow or Power Automate using Logic Apps, key takeaways, and Q&A. So feel free to ask your questions in the chat window. Nitya and Melody are here to monitor those, and they will be letting me know as and when the question will arise. So let's talk about the Power Automate. It's a low-code platform that spans across Microsoft 65, Dynamics 365, Azure, and standalone application. And one of the early members of Microsoft Power Platform was Power BI. And later on, Microsoft introduced Power Apps and Power Automate. And recently, during the November 2019, Microsoft introduced Microsoft Power Virtual Agent, which we can use to create intelligent chatbots without writing a single line of code. Now, we use Power Automate to implement end-to-end intelligent automation. And these are the value pillars of Power Automate. We can do automation at scale. It's seamless, secure integration. It builds on the serverless principle. It helps us to accelerate productivity. And we can implement intelligent automation using Power Automate. And there are many connectors available. The list is keep on growing. right now, it's more than 300. And you can build your own custom connectors as well. And with that connectors, you can integrate with your data, not only in the cloud, but also in your on-premise legacy system as well. And there is a list, growing list of template libraries available. So in case you would like to implement certain kind of automation, you can quickly check out a template library. And there you can find how to implement a particular set of automation. Let's say where you have some events happening in Azure Event Hub. And later on, you would like to do some operation in other non-Microsoft specific system, let's say Google Drive or Dropbox, or let's say AWS, then there are a lot of templates available that you can use. Now let's talk about what are Logic Apps. Logic Apps is a cloud service that helps us to schedule, automate, and orchestrate tasks, business process, and workflows. It is a de facto workflow engine in Microsoft Azure. It again, just like Power Automate, it's built on serverless principle, and it uses containerized runtime in the backend. Depending on the usage, it can scale up and down automatically to meet the demands. And one of the key advantage of going with Logic Apps is you can focus on then implementing your business logic. You don't have to worry about where my Logic App will be hosted, whether that environment is going to be secure or not, how I make sure it has the latest patches, those kind of things. You don't have to worry. Just straight up go to the Logic Apps portal, Azure portal, create a Logic App, and start implementing your business logic. Just like Power Automate, there are many connectors available, and we can use connectors across the cloud as well as on-premise. And everything begins with a trigger, and there are various triggers that are available, which we'll talk about in a few minutes. And the triggers can be time-based triggers, it can be manual, and it can be event-based trigger as well. And now if you look at the description or the overview of Power Automate and Logic Apps, they sound a little bit similar. Now let's see how these two products are connected with each other. So if you had to visualize how these two products are connected together, you can use this diagram. So Azure is one of the Microsoft public cloud offering, and Logic App is the workflow engine in Azure. And back in 2016, when Microsoft announced about Power Automate, or it used to call Microsoft Flow that time, it was built on the top of Logic Apps. That means pretty much everything you can do in Power Automate, we could do in Logic App. But over the course of time, Power Automate added its own feature as well. So there is still overlap in between the functionality of these two products and services. However, now these two products and services also has this own unique feature sets that are only available, let's say in Logic Apps, are only available in Power Automate. The designer, the lot of actions and trigger are still common both in Logic Apps and Power Automate. And when it comes to Power Automate, we can create business process flows, desktop flows, and additional actions that are now not available in Logic Apps. However, since Power Automate is built on the top of Logic App, whenever a cloud flow executes, the runtime it uses in the backend is actually the Logic App runtime. As you can see here, whenever your flow starts, it uses the Logic App runtime. It makes the API call integrate with all the services that you're using in your flow. And finally, your flow get executed. So if I show you this diagram here, so I have here two screenshots. Both the screenshots are implementing the same business logic. We're basically starting automation whenever a new item is getting created in SharePoint. Then we are initializing a bunch of variables, and then we have some condition. And if I hide few information from the ribbon and from the left-hand navigation, it's very hard for us to figure out which one is Logic App and which one is Power Automate. You can take a guess, but let me remove these banners here. So you can see here, the one on the left is from Logic Apps, and one on the right is from Power Automate. But if you focus on the middle section, where the actual business logic is implemented, it is pretty identical. That means if you are familiar with Microsoft Flow or Power Automate, then you can implement a similar business logic in Logic Apps as well. Only thing is you'll be going to Azure portal to implement that. Similarly, if you are familiar with Logic Apps and how to build your business logic around Logic Apps, then if you would like to use Power Automate, you just have to go to a different URL and Power Automate UI and start implementing your business logic. So let's talk about the key differences between these two products. So the first one is Logic Apps is part of Azure Group, and Microsoft Power Automate is part of the Business Apps Group, or Dynamics Group. Now you may be wondering why I'm talking about which product group these products are belongs to. And there is a reason for it, because depending on which product a particular product belongs to, you'll see the corresponding other products from the same umbrella will have a really tighter integration with that. For example, Logic Apps will have really good integration with other Azure DevOps and some other services. And in example of Power Automate will have very tighter integration with Power Virtual Agents, Power Apps, which are the part of Business Apps Groups. When it comes to the offering, so Logic App is available to us as integrated platform as a service offering, whereas Power Automate is available to us as software as a service offering. The licensing model of Logic App is very simple. It is just like anything in Azure. It's all based on your consumption. So we pay as per the usage, whereas in Power Automate, everything is subscription-based, and there are multiple ways you can get the license for Power Automate. The target audience for Logic Apps is IT professionals, and it's built more for enterprise-grade scenarios. And Power Automate use subset of Logic Apps, and the focus audience is citizen developers or people who would like to live in low-code, no-code environment. So with Logic Apps, we can only create Logic Apps. When it comes to Power Automate, we can create cloud flows, which are nothing but Microsoft Flow, business process flows, desktop flows. This is important things to consider whenever you're debating which one shall I use to implement my automation. Shall I go with Logic Apps or shall I go with Power Automate? So the maximum run duration for a Logic App is 90 days, whereas the same duration for Power Automate is 30 days. And this is true for cloud flows. If you are going with business process flows, then yes, you get unlimited run duration. However, for typical scenarios, if I had to compare apples to apples, then Logic App is 90 days, whereas Power Automate is 30 days, and there is no way you can bypass this limitation. Now, what does the run duration mean? Is if my instance of my Power Automate starts today, then it should finish its execution in the next 30 days. Otherwise, it will get terminated automatically. Now, what are some of the scenarios where you think your Power Automate or your Logic App may run for more than a few seconds or a few minutes? The scenarios where you're based on user input. For example, if you're using any kind of approvals, or in your Logic App, you're based waiting on some kind of event to happen. And for some reason, that event took more than 30 days to happen in Power Automate, or more than 90 days in case of Logic App, then the instances will get terminated automatically. So keep that in mind while designing your implementation and business logic. When it comes to application lifecycle management, since Logic App is part of Azure, there is a really good story available when it comes to integration with Azure DevOps, source control, and the management in Azure Resource Management. When it comes to the application lifecycle management, we can design and test in non-production environments and promote to the production environment when ready. So the story with ALM in Power Automate is like kind of a bit lagging as compared to Logic Apps. However, it is getting improved day by day. When it comes to PowerShell commandlets, we have PowerShell commandlets available for Logic Apps that we can use, and they are part of Azure ARM.Logic App module. When it comes to Power Automate, we have two modules that we can use. One is called Microsoft.PowerApps.Administration.PowerShell, and second is Microsoft.PowerApps.PowerShell modules. And you can go to this link to download the modules for it. When it comes to trigger, most of the triggers are identical. So we have manual trigger available in Logic App as well as in Power Automate. We have triggers based on an event like created, updated, and deleted. We can have Logic Apps and Power Automate start on a schedule. However, Power Automate has one extra trigger which is not available in Logic Apps. And that is a location-based trigger. It is right now in preview. However, there are some really cool scenarios we can implement using the location-based trigger in Power Automate. Now, when it comes to setup and installation, when it comes to Logic Apps, you just need to use a modern browser. And also, the code view is available. And we can also use Visual Studio for the development. When it comes to Power Automate, we have to use modern browser. If you have access to Microsoft Teams, and with your current Teams license, you can get access to Dataverse for Teams. Then you can use Teams clients with limited, with some limitations to create your Power Automate as well. When it comes to integration with SharePoint, there is no direct integration of SharePoint and Logic Apps is there. Whereas you will see some built-in SharePoint flows already available. and if I had to implement any automation where I had to do any kind of integration with SharePoint, then I have to create the automation using the Logic App Designer. Whereas if I do the same thing with Power Automate, I can do that using the modern SharePoint UI, or I can use the Power Automate Designer, or I can use Microsoft Teams client as long as I have Dataverse for Teams available to me. Now, what does that mean, like built-in flows? If you are coming from SharePoint background, and if you open a modern SharePoint site, there in the ribbon, you will see an option for automate. And using that, then you can start creating your automation directly into the SharePoint UI. When it comes to integration with on-premise data, let's say your data is in on-premise, and for some reason, you cannot move that to a public cloud. There is an option for on-premise gateways available with both the products. However, there is one caveat there. So with Logic Apps, you don't need additional license. However, if you would like to use on-premise gateway with Power Automate, you need to subscribe for additional premium license. When it comes to pricing, and that's where the majority of the decision points come, which one shall I use? So when it comes to Logic App, the pricing is very simple. Everything is based on consumption, like you pay as you go. Whereas when it comes to Power Automate, it is subscription-based. However, there is a free version of Power Automate available that anyone can sign up as long as they have a valid Microsoft account. Now, what does a valid Microsoft account means? Account with Outlook.com or Hotmail.com. If you have that, you can sign up for Power Automate for free. Power Automate is also bundled in your Microsoft 365 subscription as part of your Dynamics 365 subscription. You can also purchase some additional plans for Power Automate for per user plan or per flow plan. And also that includes attended RPA. And one of the key thing, decision point I have seen when it comes to using Power Automate, especially if you are getting a Power Automate license via a Microsoft 365 subscription, is if you have to use any HTTP action, that is a premium action, and that is not included in your regular subscription. And if I had to use that in my implementation, then I had to go with premium licenses. Now, where I will be using the HTTP action or trigger, if you have to use HTTP call to call Microsoft Graph APIs from Power Automate, if I had to call any external APIs, or if I had to call any Azure function from Power Automate, or if I had to call any Logic App from Power Automate, in that time, I had to use HTTP action. And depending on how you're getting access to Power Automate, that may or may not be included in your subscription. And let's say if you're getting Power Automate as part of your Microsoft 365 subscription, to use HTTP action, you have to go with one of the premium plans here. Now, I see there's a question, can I export a workflow from Power Automate and import into Logic App? Yes, we can do that. When it comes to exporting that, so since Power Automate is based on Logic App, there is already an option available in the UI. So if you go to the UI of Power Automate, and if you click on this More button, and if you click on Export, there is an option available where you can export that particular flow, Cloud Flow, as a Logic App template, which is nothing but a JSON file. And then we can take that JSON file, go to the Azure portal, and then we can start use that JSON file and create a new Logic App. However, whenever we do that, we have to reconfigure the connections, any connection that it may be using. And we also reconfigure any action that is no longer available in Logic App. For example, a couple of demos I have, I will show you. Like there is a specific action that is available in Power Automate that is no longer available in Logic App, and you have to do things a little bit a different way. So when it comes to integrating these two, so let's say if I have a business logic and I would like to integrate both Logic Apps and Power Automate into that, how I can do integration? When it comes to Logic Apps, I can call a flow using HTTP action. I can call a Logic App from Power Automate using HTTP action. I can also export a flow and deploy that as a Logic App. So that way I can reuse a lot of the business logic that I have already implemented. When it comes to integration with Power Virtual Agent, Power Virtual Agent is the latest member of Microsoft Power Platform. You can use it to create the no-code chatbots. And if you haven't played with this product, I would highly recommend you to just play with it, sign up for the trial. Using this, you can create a working chatbot within 30 minutes that can be used in your enterprise as well. So when it comes to integration between Logic Apps and Power Automate, if I have to call any Logic App from Power Virtual Agent, I have to first call a Power Automate, and from that I have to call Power Virtual Agent. Sorry. Yes, and if I had to do the same thing, the integration between Power Virtual Agents and Power Automate, there is an out-of-the-box action available where from Power Virtual Agent, I can call a Power Automate. And the reason for that is because both the Power Virtual Agent and Power Automate are part of the same umbrella of the product group. So you'll see there's a seamless integration available here. Whereas here, you have to do some additional steps. Eventually, the same kind of integration will be available, but whenever a new product or service get launched, typically you'll see a really good integration between the umbrella products in the same product group. With that, let's go to a quick demo. Here, what I'll be showing you is I have a Logic App here, which I'm using to create a new Microsoft Teams using the Microsoft Graph API. So let me quickly click Edit. And here the implementation is very straightforward. It starts whenever a new item gets added in the SharePoint. And when it comes to the trigger, you can have various options available. I can have a Logic App started on a specific event. I can do that manually, or I can also have that based on HTTP request as well. And then I'm initializing a bunch of variables here. And then I'm having a condition, and then I'm doing approval. So the idea is whenever a user needs to create a team, he or she will submit a request, and that request will go through an approval. And here for the approval, I'm using an email-based approval. So if the request gets approved, then only we are using the Microsoft Graph API and creating a new team using the Graph APIs here. Now, similar implementation we have done using the Microsoft Flow. So this is the Microsoft Flow, and you can see here, you just have to go to flow.microsoft.com to access it. The implementation is fairly identical. I have this new flow starts whenever a new request gets submitted. Then we initialize a bunch of variables that we require to call the Graph APIs from the Power Automate. Then we do a different kind of approval here. So the approval action we are using here is specific to Power Automate. And this approval action will give you two options to approve. We will get an email. And if I go and expand these action items in the Flow UI, here also I can go and then take action on this particular approval request. And if the request is approved, we are doing the similar implementation where we are calling Microsoft Graph API and creating a new team for us. And let's see if I have to export this particular Power Automate, and if I had to deploy that as a logic app, what will happen is, since this particular action is no longer available in Logic App, I had to delete this action and reconfigure this action using a similar action that may or may not be available there. So if I had to summarize the comparison, again, these are my personal thoughts when it comes to the comparison between these two products. When it comes to the licensing, Logic Apps wins hands down because everything is simple. You can quickly use Azure pricing calculator and find out how much charge it's going to be you. It's going to charge you depending on your consumption. Whereas Power Automate, everything is subscription based, and some actions may be premium, some may not be available in your regular license. So you have to do some checking and some math for that. When it comes to personal automation, Power Automate or Microsoft Flow wins hands down. The reason is you can get this service for free, and the free service also comes with a lot of cool features that you can use for personal automation. Now, what does the personal automation means? Personal automation means I'm using some kind of automation for my own work. For example, if I'm going to a conference and instead of checking all the emails, I can have a flow which is integrated with my mailbox. And whenever a mail comes with an important notification, or the mail comes from a manager, I get a notification via a different mechanism so that I can only check email when something important is there. When it comes to the Power user friendly, now who are the Power users? The people who doesn't write code or who prefer more kind of low code, no code scenarios. For them, Power Automate is much better. The UI and the ease of use is much higher there as compared to the Logic Apps. Because I have seen a lot of Power users struggle to navigate around Azure Portal, and you have to use Azure Portal to create Logic Apps. Again, this is my personal opinion. Your opinion may vary here. When it comes to the developer-friendly, Logic Apps wins hands down here because there is a really good integration available with other Azure services. When it comes to integration with third-party system, both are kind of equal. So overall, both the services has their plus and minus. And again, I'm giving you an answer like a typical consultant. Depending on the situation, you may use one over another. But the point I would like to make here is, if you are familiar with Logic App, don't shy away from trying Power Automate. And same thing, if you are familiar with Power Automate, don't shy away trying a Logic App, because there is not much difference when it comes to implementing your actual business logic. So if you would like to get your hands dirty, how we can get access to Power Automate without paying for it for your personal development? So there is a really good program available from Microsoft called Microsoft 365 Developer Program. You can go to this link, sign up for this program. Once you sign up, you can create your personal Microsoft 365 tenant for free. It comes with 25 users with E5 licenses. E5 is the highest level of license you can get with Microsoft 365. And in that tenant, you will have Exchange, SharePoint, Teams, Power Automate, and Power Apps. And using the same tenant, you can also sign up for free trial for Power Virtual Agent as well. Again, you can sign up for the free trial as well. But to sign up for the free trial, you need to use a credit card. To use or to create Logic App, you need access to Azure. So how you can get access to Azure, especially for your personal training and development? There are multiple ways. If you have access to MSDN, that's the preferred way. Just go to your MSDN portal and activate your monthly credit. Here, you don't need to use credit cards. This is an excellent way to try out Azure and play with its services. You can also sign up for the trial. Depending on your country, the amount, the trial amount you get may vary. However, you will need to use a credit card here. There is another program from Microsoft called Azure for Students, where you don't need a credit card. However, you need a valid EDU account from a participating school. And you get a $100 credit depending on your country. And you can go to this link to sign up for that. So hopefully the content we covered today made you familiar with the key differences between Power Automate and Logic App. And if you don't have access to a personal developer tenant, definitely check out Microsoft 365 Developer Program. With that, we come to an end. And these are my contact details. Feel free to email me or connect me with, on Twitter or on LinkedIn. With that, thank you very much for coming. Stay safe and stay healthy.
Well done, Prashant.
Thank you.
Yeah, I must say that has to be the most comprehensive like coverage of Logic Apps and Power Automate and everything that you need to know about them. I really like the fact that you put those links for personal use, because I think that anytime I look at one of these conferences, I know a lot of people want to go play with it, and to give them just enough that they can go and deploy and try stuff out is awesome. So this was amazing. I know there was one question which I must say you answered in line. I don't know if you planned this, but it was a perfect segue. The other comment that I love is someone on chat, Simon said, sure, Power Automate and Logic Apps are interesting, but I want to hear more about your Antarctica service medal. So you need to write a blog post on that.
Sure, we'll do that.
I don't know if there's a whole bunch of questions that were answered. So you should definitely go check out the chat. Okay. I had one quick question for you. Because we're talking about serverless, and I've heard two really good technologies, the coming added from the Azure side and Power Platform. Do you have a resource for best practices for serverless integrations with Logic Apps? And like, I know Power Platforms has a practices and patterns kind of a movement, but are there any kind of best practices based on different usage scenarios?
So what you're talking about is the Center of Excellence kit for Power Platform. That's a good way to start with the Power Platform. And if you just search on docs.microsoft.com, you will find tons of information regarding the best practices, not only for Logic Apps, but other serverless technologies as well, like Azure Functions or Cosmos DB as well.
Well, thank you very much. And huge shout out to the two conferences you're running. We should definitely amplify them. Can't wait to see that.